basically a matchup where the treasure cruise is too much better than the dig through time, that to rationalize the dig through time as a fifth cruise. Just too much pressure on our mana base. Yeah, Smash to Smithereens was so good. I was playing a deck earlier and played against Death and Taxes, and I was just like, if I could just kill every every darn artifact I saw, I'd be in really good shape. And so, like, the 3 Smash plan, I like that a lot. Especially because it's so good against the Chalice plan, too. That's the main reason for all the Smashes. So I'm going to keep this and hope that my opponent doesn't turn 1 Mother Runes me, but... That's a turn 1 Aether Vial. Let me tell you about a card that's good against turn 1 Aether Vial. Might be Smash. Might be Smash to Smithereens. Our hand is weak to Wasteland, though. Maybe the deck needs a couple more red fetches. Oh god, he just passed. He just passed? Alright, I'm gonna... Normally, I would never probe Pre-Pyromancer, but I want to see if there's anything weird going on. 1 land Vial hand on the play against an opponent that you know has Smash to Smithereens. Might just be awkward. I guess I could see keeping it if you had like a Plow and a Thalia, like 2 cards that are just like really important in the matchup. We'll see though. We'll see if he reacts to this probe or not. Oh, interesting. Path to Exile. Yeah, pretty much everybody plays Swords to Plowshares. Yeah, this Smash to Smithereens is just the sickest thing ever. So he's gonna path us here, but we actually really do not mind getting pathed. That is just not a thing we care about. It's getting the path out of his hand so he can't path the Young Pyromancer, and then we're going to be able to play Young Pyromancer plus removal spell on like every creature he plays for the rest of the game. Which seems pretty absurd. It should just be the match. I'm gonna call us like 90% to win this game. Yeah. 90% to murder his face off. We really want him to path, so yeah. Now I just don't think we're gonna lose too much. He would need to rip like some kind of a god. Oh, he got his land. Now he's a Stoneforge Mystic. Stoneforge Mystic isn't nearly as scary as Thalia though, that is for sure. And we know he only had the 1 path at the time, so we would have had to draw another removal spell to deal with, you know, Pyromancer. And what does his Stoneforge Mystic get? Got a Sword of Fire and Ice. A pretty strong card against us, to be sure, but he's just not going to have the time or tempo to deal with it. So I'll play another Young Pyromancer. Bolt your guy. And we've just got like a mini army here. There's another Stoneforge Mystic, that's fine. Swift Spears. He blocks Swift Spear, I can price. And now his hope is to Stoneforge Mystic in Batterskull, but we know that we have another Smash to Smithereens, so that is not going to be good. Yeah, there's no reason to slow roll anything. He's gonna use this attack with all button and blow up his Batterskull after he gets into play. Smash to Smithereens, overperforming, mutagenic growth, underperforming. That is what I have learned from these matches. Oh, there's a match. Sweet. So before you guys leave, I want to quickly go over what I liked and did not like about this list. I really didn't like the Miser mutagenic growth. And while Dig Through Time was kind of good in some matchups, it was kind of atrocious in others. So I would cut both of these cards entirely. Well, maybe the Dig Through Time wouldn't be bad out of the sideboard. I really liked the 3 Force of Wills. I think that's really strong. I think what I would do is cut one of these islands for the 4th Volcanic Island. And then with that extra mountain in the deck, I think you can go up to 2 Fire Blasts. Just so that you can, like, hypothetically actually cast 2 Fire Blasts in a game. I think that's the main thing stopping me from playing 2 Fire Blasts in this list right now. It's just that the mountain count is so very low. Like, if your opponent wastelands you, you wouldn't actually have enough mountains in the deck. But two is a decent number. And then I might go up to 2 Price of Progress as well. Another option is a Miser Forkbolt in the main deck, which I kind of like as well. Yeah, I think I would have 1 Forkbolt, and then either a 2nd Preordain, or a 2nd Fire Blast, or a 2nd Price of Progress. And that would just be the list that I would like, I think. Maybe Dig Through Time is correct. Yeah, I guess I actually don't hate the dig still. Even though it was awkward in a couple draws that I had, it was still like that bit of gas. Where if I was playing a Treasure Cruise Mirror, or if my opponent was disrupting me, it would be like this game-winning card. Yeah, I still like it. And the 4th Force of Will wouldn't be the worst thing ever either, especially because we have the Dig Through Time. But I think another burn spell is going to be better in that slot. I think I would play the Miser Forked Bolt. I've convinced myself. The Miser Forked Bolt. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Sorry I didn't have anything like wild or crazy going on this week. But this is the just like I said, I think it's the best deck in the format. I think it's what everybody should be playing. And hopefully I've convinced a couple of you that that's just the case. Treasure Cruise is really, really strong. And we even played a matchup or two that we weren't even necessarily, like, favored, quote-unquote favored. And the deck still performed admirably. And Smash to Smithereens. Very strong card. Don't leave home without it. Caleb out.